This is callaloo. This is very popular in the countryside of Jamaica, in the mountains. You know, not really popular in the city. City people know about it, but they don't really have, you know, access unless they want to spend a lot of money, and usually they don't. So that's callaloo. I plant my own callaloo. So I'm gonna try to make this video. Well, I am gonna make this video, not try, more callaloo, about how I cut the callaloo from my garden and prepare it. So this much callaloo from that one patch right there. This is enough for a whole meal. And this cool thing is, a week from now, I can cut once again from that same spot. Those same plants will generate as much a week from now, and I can do it for about 5 weeks. That's really great, you know. So this is my callaloo all cut up, right? In addition to that, from my garden, I have sweet peppers. I have one habanero pepper, one scotch bonnet pepper. I have green onions. Quiet. And I have tomatoes, all from the garden. So these I'm gonna cut up. The green onions, I will cut them up and add them to this. These I will cut up and saute, and then add the color to it. Okay, so the green onion I plant the same time I plant the callaloo. They grow about the same speed, so every time I cut callaloo, I always have green onions to cut. And so like I said, the callaloo lasts me about 5 weeks. After about 4 or 5 weeks, I pull them out and I plant more. So for the most part, year round, I have callaloo available to eat, except for in the cold months, which is like January, February. And that's when I plant cabbage, you know. Yeah, in the cold months, I plant stuff like cabbage and lettuce and spinach. They can handle the cold weather, you know. So there's always something in my garden, regardless of the weather conditions. I'm all prepped, I'm all prepared. Callaloo cut, you know, tomatoes and peppers to saute, frying pan, and then, so I can use regular salt with callaloo. Callaloo requires, you know, more salt than usual for the taste. But I like to use, and most Jamaicans like to use, salt fillet for salt fish. So this is pork fillet salted, you know, salted. So what I do with this is I get a little piece, because this is more about flavor. It's not like necessarily that I want to eat, I need to eat the fish. I will eat the fish, but it's really about flavor. So I try to use just enough, you know, this is just enough to get the salt flavor. I just noticed that I have garlic in the fridge. So I think I'm gonna add a couple of cloves of garlic to my saute over there, since I didn't add any garlic. So here's my garlic cloves. For my saltfish to heat up. When that boils up, I have to watch it because it bubbles up. So I keep an eye on it. And then I cook the fish for a little bit so the fish can get soft and so the salt gets out in the water. A couple things I'm doing for the first time that I haven't done before cooking callaloo is I'm using habanero pepper. Usually I don't use habanero pepper because it's really, really extra spicy. But I've noticed recently that I haven't been satisfied with the amount of spice I'm getting from the scotch bonnet pepper. So I added a small habanero. And something else that I haven't done is I haven't used olive oil. So I'm using olive oil this time. My experience is I've always been happy using olive oil for anything that I usually use vegetable oil for. So I think this is gonna turn out good. So the oil is hot, let me turn it off because the fish is not ready. That's the fish, baby. So that's been boiling for about 5 minutes. See, I've already washed my cutting board and put it away. So instead of getting my cutting board all dirty again, I use the pot cover to break up the fish. I add the fish to the saute stuff. Salt water from the salt fish. A little bit of seasoning. This is just general seasonings that I put in everything that I cook. You know, there's nothing special, you know, just stuff that I like to use. I think I use some of my chili peppers. Why not? Yeah? He's not hungry.
Yes, he is.
He's not hungry. He's just smelling. He's smelling.
What's that, son? A kitten?
Yeah.
One, that's your kitten? Is it a he or?
It's a boy, yeah. Oh, look, he found the ball.
It's
so cute, right?
Yeah, he's so cute.
He's my dog.
No. Mine!
He's yours.
What's your
name, dog? Dog.
Nossa!
What? I knew he was gonna come to the phone.
Just taste this. It's amazing, yo. Everything is right. I can taste the sweetness of the sweet pepper and the spice from the habanero, like, woo! Mucha bella, mozzarella, bizarre. You know what I mean? That should taste good.
Here's the big cat.
You got a new little friend?
Oh. Here's the final step. I use this strainer and I drain off the liquid. This is not necessary, actually, but you know, if you leave the callaloo with the liquid, it gets like soggy and stuff. So I like to leave it, you know, complete the cycle. You know what I mean?
Here's my glass container.
There you have it, callaloo cooked from the garden.
And in the process of cooking the callaloo, guess what shows up? A new kitten. A new house cat.
This cat is more wildcat. He likes to be outside. I think the new kitten will be more of a house cat.
Because we found that cat outside. This cat was given to us.
Ew, son, what you doing under the bed? Trying to get somebody?
That's funny.
You have a roof.